Hello friends, welcome to Stroller's Diary for some more fun facts and Jamshedpur adventure. So today I am at Sadarabji Park at Jamshedpur. On 3rd of March, which is the Founders Day of Jamshedpur, the city is beautifully decorated. Each part of Jamshedpur city you will find lightings. So today I am heading towards the heart of Jamshedpur, that is the Jubilee Park. So all these days, due to the pandemic, the park was closed. Hoping that today it'll be open for the visitors. People visit Jamshedpur on 3rd March to see the beauty of the city from in and around the city. So let's go to Jubilee Park and see if it's open today or not. We headed our journey from Telco Colony to Tin Plate and then to Golmuri and then Sakchi. Moving to Bistapur was really exciting, viewing all the beautiful lightings around. So we crossed several roundabouts or say Gol Chakkar, which were beautifully decorated. All the Gol Chakkars or the roundabouts you see was fully lighted, decorated for the Founders Day. Viewing all this, we reached our destination to Jubilee Park. And unfortunately, no entry for public here, the entrance of the Jubilee Park where it was closed. So it was lighted up well inside, but we were told that it is not open for public even today. So we headed our journey towards Sadarabji Park, which was our second destination today. We were sure now that this will also not be open for the public. So here we reach, and this is the road outside the park. So this is the park which is situated opposite to Kiran Stadium in Bistapur, beside Sacred Heart School. The park boasts of well-maintained garden, brilliant water fountains and gorgeous waterbeds. This park spreads over 2.5 acres. In 1995, this park was created to commemorate the contribution of Sir Dorabji Tata to the country, the city of Jamshedpur and the Tata Group. It was designed as a vibrant recreational space for the citizens of Jamshedpur. Originally, the park had two rose gardens, three fountains and a life-size statue of Sir Tata. After 25 years, the park was re-envisioned and rededicated to the public. During the upgradation of the park, a statue of Lady Meherbai Tata, wife of Sir Tata, has been added, and a steel tubular structure and pavilion through which the legacy of famous Jubilee Diamond has been immortalized in steel. In a country obsessed with the legend of Kohinoor, little public attention is paid to the fact that there were far larger diamonds in India until very recently. The Jubilee Diamond was once owned by Sir Dorabji Tata. It is almost double the size of the famous Kohinoor Diamond. Till the late 19th century, India and Brazil were the only known sources of diamonds. But the discovery of diamond mines in South Africa in 1860s opened a new chapter in the history of the gem. The Jubilee Diamond was discovered in Jagersfontein mine of South Africa in 1895. It was originally a rough stone of whopping 650 carats and was acquired by the Consortium of London-based diamond merchants, who originally named it as Ritz Diamond in honor of Francis William Ritz, the then president of the Orange Free State in present-day South Africa, in which the Jagersfontein mine is located. In 1900, the diamond was exhibited in Paris exhibition, where it was a star attraction. Soon after, it was bought by Sir Dorabji Tata, who presented it to his wife Lady Meherbai Tata. This was an interesting time for the Tatas, as they were making a transition from being Bombay mill owners to becoming industrialists. The Taj Mahal Hotel at Bombay opened its doors in 1903, Tata Steel Tisco in 1907, while Tata Power was established in 1910. However, in 1924, the Tata Steel, then called Tisco, was on a verge of collapse due to cheaper Japanese iron flooding in the market. The young company faced a severe liquidity crunch and needed almost Rs 2 crores, a substantial sum at that time, to pay outstanding wages and for the repayment of debentures. At such a time, it was the Jubilee Diamond which came to Tata's rescue. Business historians like R.M. Lala and Geeta Piramal write how Sir Dorabji Tata pledged the diamond and other jewellery with the Imperial Bank of India, now SBI, as a collateral for the loan. The money was raised and Tata Steel got saved. Lady Meherbhai Tata, though not well remembered like her husband, was a formidable lady in her own right. A staunch campaigner for women's rights, she was
one of the founders of the Bombay Presidency Women's College and National Council for Women.
Sadly, Lady Meherbhai died of leukemia in 1931 and soon after so did Sir Dorabji in 1932. In his will, Sir Dorabji Tata bequeathed his entire wealth, including the Jubilee Diamond, to Sir Dorabji Tata Trust. By 1935, the trustees, who included J.R.E. Tata and Sir Homi Modi, sold the jewellery
and from the money funded
the famed Tata Memorial Hospital. The diamond was sold to a French industrialist who sold it to Lebanese diamond magnate Robert Mowawad. The Jubilee Diamond is presently in the Mowawad collection. Today, the Jubilee Diamond lies hidden in a secure vault, but it is ever remembered for its fascinating but short Indian connection. So this was a story of the precious and priceless Jubilee Diamond. So Sir Dorabji Park is a must-visit place with family and friends. For some more fun facts and adventures, stay tuned with Stroller's Diary. Do like, share and subscribe my channel. And I'll be back with some more fun facts and adventure. Thank you for watching.